Hello people, welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to talk about my character design process.
Do I have to be here for that?
Why? Do you have to be somewhere? Did you forget that you're just here because I felt the need to have all my self-doubts and insecurities present in the form of my younger self, just so he can yap at me whenever he feels it's appropriate?
You're welcome?
Yeah, still figuring out why I thought this was a good idea.
So you're saying I should be here or shouldn't?
Okay, let's head on. How do I design my characters? Actually, sometimes I happen to have a first ballpark in the animatic. So if that's the case, I'll take it as a reference. I'll draw my first rough draft. For a while, I tried around with basic geometric shapes, since these are a common method to easily recreate your characters from different perspectives, but I found out that that is too simple for me. I like to give them some character by using individual shapes that are loosely based on human anatomy. Most of the time, my heads are deliberately oversized. The first draft deals with the location of the joints and bones. I then define the proportions by drawing the skin. This is also important as a reference later for the animations. Then I do the second draft on top of the first one. This drawing has all the details and clothes. When that is done, I use it to trace over the outlines. I like to use outlines that maintain their thickness. After that is time for the colors, which go on a separate layer under the outlines. I don't like my colors too punchy, but that really is a choice of taste. By the way, I try to keep as much as possible on separate layers, so I have maximum flexibility later on. I use Blender for my whole character design process, since it has this very powerful grease pencil feature. It is vector based and I can also do my frame by frame animation right in there. And since I like to combine my characters with 3D objects, this is the perfect solution for me. After I finished my character, I start to add in the animations. Which ones I need really depends on the animatic and what the character does and says throughout the script. This whole part needs to be planned well because it is traditional animation. Mostly I make these animations for the hand gestures, blinks, and mouth sets. For the latter, I don't create all the seams that character animator provides because I animate on a 12 frame basis. And most of the time, 8 mouth shapes are enough to get a believable mouth movement. Sometimes I create alternative mouth sets, for example, for smiling or frowning. If I want to use my character in Adobe Character Animator, I need to export every layer as an image to be able to assemble it in Photoshop. And there I set everything up to be used in Character Animator. For just classical animation, meaning no use of Character Animator, I could just stay in Blender. Okay, there you go. That is how I create my characters. Hope you enjoyed it. Wait, you didn't interrupt me once. Do you feel all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Just trying to earn my keep.
As always, please express your feelings about this video by liking and or subscribing. See you next time.
Boxes are defeated. Purpose always fleeting. I pose questions to the ceiling like an answer gonna come. Truth is too revealing. Life is easier concealing. All emotions to the start on your heart going numb. I shouldn't be in drive more. I just wanna feel alive more. I feel hurt all the time, boy. I can't.